She packed my bags last night, pre-flight. 0 hour, 9 a.m. And I'm gonna be high as a kite by then. I miss the earth so much. I miss my wife. It's lonely out in space on such a timeless flight. Touchdown brings me round again to find I'm not the man they think I am at home. Oh no, 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 I'm a rocket man. Rocket man, burning out his fuse out there at home. And I think it's gonna be a long, long time till touchdown brings me round again. In fact, it's cold as hell, and there's no one there to raise them. If you did, and all the science I don't understand, it's just my job.
Yes, 20 years or so went by before their true desires were sated. Years of unruly antics and dangerous escapades, chased by gangsters and Venetian police and Amazonian crusades. Although seemingly chaotic and precarious and somewhat ill-advised, the pair were aficionados of chaos organized. Nearly done. Their unconventional approach to life is one of their greatest charms. Amy facing adversity and the unknown with open arms. Their love is as wild and untamed as the jungles where they've danced, and the family and friends around them have had their lives enhanced by this couple of teenage boppers who excel in controlled hysteria. who invite us to go back to basics and throw excess to every area. All of us here stand ready, enthusiastic and awaiting to support this high voltage dynamic duo, this marriage in the making. We'll be their roadies, their groupies, their audience, their fans. We'll keep their DJ booth and polish their cans. And right up to the encore, we'll be dancing and cheering. We'll turn up their monitors when they become hard of hearing. We'll celebrate solstice round their Taoist maypole. We'll calm the oceans and be their rock when they roll. We'll calm the oceans and be their bridesmaids, their ushers, their advisors, their ports in a storm. We will come to your aid when the fair weather turns foul and needs thinking outside the norm. We'll write your coma diary by your bedside. Through many days and nights, we'll be your travel agents, your tour managers when you miss your flights. And so today, we take time in life's busy race to hold you both in our family embrace.
A house with no curtains tells no lies. So, and in the words of Joe Strummer, he said that if you haven't got your word, you're nothing, you know. Your word, you might not have money, you might not have wealth, but if you've got your word, then you're wealthy. And also, and something I've always stood by, and today, I promised to always keep my word to you, Emmy. To love you. Yeah, like nobody's ever loved you before. And again. But I'm going to love her in this life and in the afterlife. Again, like there's a few people that are not here today, like my mum, and my auntie mum passed this week, and Alistair, of course, Howard Marks, Joe, there's many people that are not here. But Howard actually said to me once, he said, I overheard you say, I can't do a Welsh accent, but he said, you may not understand everything I'm saying, but you may only understand 10%, but I can assure you that 10% is fucking excellent. I said, did I say that, Howard? He said, yes, you did, but before you get carried away, just think what you could have achieved with the other 90%. I'm going to pass you over to Amy now. I want to say thanks to Beth for being my bestie, and Joe, and my children for being here, and all of you, and I'll just, you know how we are. I love her, you know what I mean? That's all I can say, really.
Testing, 1, 2, 1, 2. How can I even start to top that, you know? But me, I've known Dave since I was, 20, 21, and he was the first person I had a big loss in my family. I lost my brother, like Alistair. Alistair died in a car crash. I lost my brother. Moved to Leeds and met this wonderful, wonderful man. And little did I know what a big part. I knew he would play a part in my life. I didn't realise quite how big it was going to be, but it was I knew we were going to be together, you know, and we've had our highs, we've had our lows, and I'm not saying it's not been a challenge, you know, but we're all learning. We're all learning. Every day's a learning day, Dave. Yeah. I love him, and the world wouldn't be the same without him.
Yeah. You two can definitely kiss. Bert, have you got those rings?
Maybe I.
All right.
Didn't treat you quite as good as I should have. Maybe I didn't love you quite as often as I could have. Little things I should have said and done, I just never took the time. You were always on my mind.
Always
all those lonely, lonely times.
God, by your blessing, let these rings be to Dave and Amy a symbol of unending love and faithfulness, to remind them of the vows, the covenants they are making this day to love one another. That's great. So, yeah. I know this is. Right. Okay. So it's. Okay. So say these words as you put it on. Amy, I give you this ring.
As a sign of our marriage.
With my body, I honour you.
All I am, I give to you.
All I have, I share with you.
Within the love of all gods.
Dave, I give you this ring.
As a sign of our marriage.
With my body, I honor you. All that I am, I give to you. All that I have, I share with you.
Within the love of God.
Okay.
Amen.
Therefore, I'm going to say kiss. Oh, come on.